What is good, friends? We are back with more World Cup action. We got Ricardo versus P2, and this is pretty funny because I knew Ricardo would bring some meme stuff because his team is already in the next round. So he decided to bring a Laurentis. What am I gonna make him a neck trick? I could see this being Z Move Greninja or Scarf Greninja. Roxlandros is pretty obvious. I just don't know if it's Z Move or or defensive. Z Move or Offbit or defensive, not sure yet. I think it's defensive and Spidef Sila, so this is a defensive core. This could also be defensive with Defog, so the Landers could be offensive. Yeah, I'm not really sure about that. But I think it's gonna be Scarf Greninja, because he's weak to Volcarona. But yeah, this is the team that Jammed used and Blunder used a version of it. The team that Jammed used was like Scarf Duggy with I think Bantar. And the version that Blunder used was Z-Move Duggy, because Ray Scarf is usually brings like more fatter teams, cause so like Z-Move Duggy is better than Scarf Duggy versus that. And then he changed the Tita to Assault Vest because he was weaker to Volcarona when the Duggy's not Scarf Stone Edge anymore. But yeah, he leads up with the Gren. I assume this is just gonna U-turn out, turn one and then Scarf. But I might be wrong. But I assume it's Scarf Protein. Yep, exactly. Whew. Like otherwise he's just way too weak to Volcarona. Like look at it. He Scarf Lele Volcarona mercs him. So he goes for Stone Edge, I assume that's defensive land on Bandit T-Tar. Goes for U-turn to maintain offensive momentum. And does he have anything to pressure the Mew is the question. Manectric I'm pretty sure can't kill the Mew. It looks like the Mew kind of walls this entire team. I could see the Tapu Lele being the Z-Move user. I know Ricardo likes that set, the All Out Pummeling one, he has used it. He has used it in the OST round 1 or 2, I don't remember, like a few months ago. But yeah, this is really annoying, this Mew. But if he has Taunt on Tapu Lele, I can see him going for that. I mean, I can see Shachel Tapu Lele, but I think I'm leaning a bit more towards the Lele being Z-Move. Hopefully Laurentis will put in some work, that's my biggest wish, boy. Whew. But yeah, Ricardo is 2-0 so far, P2 is 2-0-2. I only uploaded one of P2's games, because the second game was a bit weird, and I recorded like one at night, and I would have to re-narrate over it because I couldn't talk, and I don't think the game was really worth it. Not that they played bad or anything, but it just wasn't a game that I enjoyed that much. Like, they were taking 3 minutes every turn, and then they just pretty much... I don't know how to put it in words, but I just didn't feel like uploading that game. So U-turns that again. He could have stayed in and roosted, I think, or softballed, if I'm trying, like, same thing. So now there's the... Is he gonna Volt Switch? He's just gonna protect first, right? Yeah, to get the lefties. He goes for HBIs, he tries to predict the Duck Trio. HBIs again, boy. He's gonna go Duggy now. Watch. Doubles out on the Celeste dealer. Yeah, I think he predicted Volt Switch or HBIs. Nice play from P2's part. Yeah, I think that was a fine play from P2, and I can also understand. I can understand both players' plays. Double into Manectric and Zard, really nice play. He's probably gonna Volt Switch here, even though I can see P2 going into the Duggy. Thing is, Zard doesn't get O-code from Manectric. It might O-code with the roll, I think. I don't remember 100%. But like, is it worth it to go for HBIs and potentially lose your Manectric here if the Zard stays in? Also, if the Tita comes in and you go for HBIs, you get bopped by Pursued. So this turn is like, it's pretty prediction based, it's tough. Did he Volt Switch? He went for HBIs, which I can understand, because you never know when P2 will go to Duggy. And if it's Scarf Duggy, it's gonna be so bad. So he's probably gonna click Pursuit here to get rid of the Manectric. So if it's Banta, right, it should be Banta from the damage that it did to the Landris. I can see Ricardo clicking T-Bolt here to predicting that Tita to go for Pursuit. He clicks HBIs, predicting him to pivot in the Duggy. Okay, that didn't work out. But he just clicked Pursuit. I thought he would crunch there, predicting Ricardo's a T-Bolt. Because like, it was pretty obvious that he wouldn't vault switch and let this get pursued, I feel. But yeah, now he gets pursued anyway. The Manectric is pretty much dead. I mean, he can still T-bolt to pick... Oh my god, that did nothing with a crit. Maybe it's a Salt Vest then. I have to calc. I have to calc if it's a Salt Vest. If a T-bolt critted only 33, I'm not sure anymore. Tyranta pursued at 33 to Manectric. I'm just gonna calc Scarf because it's the same damage that a Salt Vest would do. Let's take the Intimidate away. It does 20. Yeah, okay, so it's probably AV then. So this seems to be offensive Landris then. I think it's AV. So the Dugget's gonna be Z-move. Yeah, that's an offensive Landris for sure. Earthquake doing 52. Not sure if it's Earthblade actually. You where's Lando? Is there Earthblade in the calculator? I don't think there is. Let's say Earthblade. Let's say Bolt Mew. Give it like 140 defense, however. I don't know how much they run exactly. But it could be Earthblade if the Mew's fist death. But yeah, just click Softball on the U-turn. The Grin is gonna click U-turn here because he's gonna get momentum or kill the Mew. But yes, yeah, this is looking pretty good for P2. Like, I think it was a tough matchup for Ricardo. He already set himself in the back by bringing the Lorenzo's JKJK, but like, this is just hard. Like, the combination of Zard with Tita and Dug in the back is scary to play against. Like, I would never want to play against such a combination. He obviously has Rock Slide on this, really nice double switch, because he cannot give the Zard free switch in, because if the Zard gets a free switch in on stuff like Celesteela, he will just get a kill. So I completely agree with Ricardo's play there. I think he's just gonna have to U-turn out here. Because like, P2 is not gonna stay and risk the Rock Slide. I can also see him double switching, not wanting to take the iron bobs from the Ferrothorn, but he just U-turns, which is fine, yep. Yeah, he just sacked the T-Tide to get momentum back, that's fine. The thing is, now Zardwai gets a kill, right? Depending what he goes to. If he's Timid Gigavolt Havoc Tapu Lele, maybe he should go out into that. Yeah, he goes Tapu Lele. Like, if he's Gigavolt Havoc, would that Okura Zard if he's Timid? Let's just say Z Thunder. I don't think it would Okura, right? Oh, it does Oko, okay. Holy fuck, that is a lot. Let's say Zard has some HP investment. Still Oko's. I don't think he is that set, but he has to like at least bluff that he's that set, or like... Because like, if he goes into anything else, Zard would have just gotten a kill if he went into like these 3 months. So I can completely understand why he went into this. Because if it's Timid and the Zard is modest, I think the Zard is modest flamethrower on this team. He at least gets a good damage on the Zard. But yeah, this matchup is so tough for Ricardo, like I said. Like, who wants to play against Zard Tita? Like, it's such an annoying combination. Goes out into Dark Trio, which I think he's Ground Z. Yeah, he's Ground Z, and he's just gonna click the Ground Z and kill the Tapu Lele. Yeah, he's just gonna kill it. Because we already know it's Scarf Greninja, so it's not Scarf Lele. Yeah, this game is over. Zardwai just clicks buttons now. Unless P2 chokes, he's not gonna choke though. I mean, it's fair. Ricardo won the two games where it mattered, and this game didn't matter, and he brought Laurentius. Didn't work out, what can you say? I think this is the third time that we see this team in World Cup after Jammed Blunder used it, like I said. He used a version of it, and I think P2 brought the version that Blunder used. So it's Earthblade Landers, like I thought. Like, after calking and figuring out that the Tita was a Salt Vest instead of Choice Band, I figured out that it's probably Earthblade from the damage that it did to the defensive Bolt Mew. So he's just gonna get up a Hazard. Oh, he Leech Seeded again, okay. What does Laurentius even do? I know it gets Defog and Synthesis and Leaf Storm, and it has the contrary ability that Superior also has. He said, what does this do? Find out. I think it runs Leaf Storm, Hidden Power, Fire, Synthesis, and Defog. 45 speed. Yeah, like the thing that it has over Superior, it has a really nice special attack stat. But it's pretty slow. And it gets Defog, which is nice, I guess. Yeah, I assume it's gonna be the Synthesis Leech Seed. Not Leech Seed, Synthesis Leaf Storm, HP Fire Set. With Defog in the last slot. I was just thinking about the game earlier where Flame Victini's team was used by PEC, and it didn't work out too well, which like shows how specific a team can be. Like, I think Flame Victini built specifically for Gemmed and it worked out. So he Leaf Storms it up and he just knocks off. So this is gonna, yeah, this has HP Fire, obviously. He doesn't want to go hard into Zard with Rock Sub. What is he gonna do here? Mew is pretty low. Well, Lorenzo might get a kill. That would be fire if Lorenzo gets a kill. Oh, there's no extension in round one. So if the people don't play, deadline is in like 4 hours. Who doesn't play is just... the game just doesn't count? Do you get a loss or does the game just doesn't count for both teams? I don't know. Do both teams get a loss? I don't know how it works. I mean, the HP fire is kind of obvious, but it's not like he has good switch-ins to that. So this might get one kill, but after that, that Y is just going to come in and... nah, he might want to default before he goes to that Y. He goes to Dagi. I assume the HP fire is coming here. Leaf storms again. Bop. It's another boost, booth. Yeah, I guess that, yeah, the Ferrothorn couldn't do anything to the Lurantis. So he goes to that way, he's willing to take the rocks before he defogs with the Mew. He says, let's get Lurantis out of here. This boy is getting a bit too scary. Let's get this mon out of here. He's gonna click Flamethrower here like 100,000,000%. Like, he's not playing around with a plus 4 mon. He goes hard Greninja, scares this out with a rock slide. I can see Ricardo doubling here. Because he doesn't want to take Iron Barbs from the Ferrothorn. Please don't go for U-turn. Please double switch. Okay, Rock Slides in case he stayed in. Like, I can understand why he made that play, but I would... like, this, like, he's just so far in the back. Oh, he tried to... oh, he gets the flinch. I guess he was just trying to, like, catch him on a double or something into Mew. Trying to catch a double into Mew to get the defog off. I can see that. So yeah, this is a tough turn for Ricardo, because like Flamethrower kills the Ferrothorn. Actually, it's not a tough turn, because the Zard is at 51. For some reason, I thought the Zard could come in here. So Flamethrower was a completely fine play, because Zard is at 1% and would have died. At first, I thought Zard is at full and could come in for free then. But yeah, Mew's gonna soft boil up here. But Ricardo actually made this game really close, man. I thought like P2 had this one, but like the rocks obviously helped with Zard were. Pretty sure P2 is gonna defog here, and Ricardo's gonna click Leaf Storm, start boosting. But the problem is that Zardwai is too much pressure for him. I would go for Leaf Storm here, and he's gonna go for defog, right? And then the next one, I would probably double switch into. Oh, he just goes for Ice Beam. Whoa. I really thought he would want to get the defog off. I just saw some. Yeah, it's not important. There was something in my room that like caught my attention. Let's put it that way. Something ran through my room. Some animal, let's put it that way. I catch that animal after the game. But he sacks off the Lurantis to two Ice Beams and... I mean, eventually he's gonna defog, right? I'm still waiting for the defog. He did burn the Cell Stealer, so Ricardo's fishing for Flamethrower burn. PS2 Cell Stealer puts in a lot of work. Like, it beats Ricardo Cell Stealer 1-1, because Ricardo Cell Stealer is burned and his isn't burned. Yeah, but he finally went for the defog. He gets in the Greninja, gets the... recovery from the Leech Seed. He's going to U-turn here. So the Slanderous is going to go for Rocks or Smackdown. Hard into Mew. On a U-turn, Ricardo playing aggressive. I like it. I mean, he might just go for Soft Ball because he can live a U-turn potentially. But maybe he cannot live it because it might be max attack or something. I'm not sure. Did someone else start a game? Ricardo's playing 3D chess right now. Goes for rocks. And I can see Mahard switching out here, predicting Project, but he just U-turns again. And a Celesteela. Nice flamethrower play. I mean, Ricardo's playing this well, but I don't know if he can bring it back. He's just gonna click Leech Seed here. Yeah, it's just tough for Ricardo. If he still had his Lorandus, he could play around a bit, because then he would go for Flamethrower and not Leech Seed every turn. I guess he's trying to PP stall this. I don't think this works out for him. He still has enough Leech Seeds left. I don't even know which game is left. I recorded pretty much most of the games that I wanted to record, besides like two where my internet crashed, which was the Thorn versus some Grease guy, and what was the other game that I wanted to record? I forgot. Goes for Smackdown, and I think he can just U-turn here, right? Yeah, he goes for U-turn. Greninja come in, Greninja goes for U-turn again, and this is pretty nice, because now he has Rocks up. So he can put some offensive pressure. He goes for Ice Beam instead. Did he get a freeze? He did get a freeze. That's why he said that in the chat. Okay, so I think, yeah, I guess U-turning wouldn't have gained him, got him anything. Okay, this is getting really scary. Okay, he said he had a heart attack. I think he thawed out. Did he thaw? He probably thawed out last turn and went for Heavy Slam and killed the Greninja, yeah. A flamethrower, okay. Damn, that was a close one. The freeze, man. Greninja could have won that game. But yeah, now Mew should win this game. I think it has Ice Beam, right? Did it show Ice Beam? I think it did, yeah. So he can kill this with Earthquake or a Smackdown. Yeah, Smackdown is a safer play in case he goes Zard and just clicks Ice Beam with the faster Mew and picks up the win. But yeah, this was a cool meme team, I guess. And that's another game that started, so I'll say thank you guys for watching. And pretty cool game. It didn't really matter for the next round, like I said, but it was fun to watch. And yeah, like I said, this team is good, and I would not want to play against such a core. And peace out, friends. Stay tuned for more World Cup coverage. Goodbye.